What's up, guys? So today we got a brand new video for you. We also got a brand new giveaway to talk about. And this month we're going to be giving away a multi-purpose digital meter. Now this thing does a number of different things for you. I have one. I absolutely love this device. And it makes mixing salt water and a number of other things very, very easy. So if you want to be in the running for this giveaway, all you need to do is be a subscriber. Hit the like button on this video and leave a comment down below, and you may win yourself a Seaside Aquatics salinity meter. So in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at the top five most stunning soft corals. And if you're relatively new to reef keeping, what a soft coral is essentially a coral that doesn't have a skeleton. Now the term soft coral is not necessarily a scientific classification. It's more of a hobby generated term to define a type of coral. In most cases, soft corals are considered beginner friendly, which what a beginner friendly coral is something that can withstand parameter swings. It's very hardy, it's resilient, but there's always exceptions to the rule. There are some expert level corals out there, and we will touch on a few of those in today's video. And the importance of talking about that is the fact that you can't just go out and buy stuff. You have to do your research. You have to know the care level of the animals that you're buying so you can take care of their needs and make sure that they have a long, happy life. So without further ado, let's jump into the top five most stunning soft corals. Coming in at number five on the top five most stunning soft corals is the toadstool leather. Now, this specimen is incredibly stunning with its almost porcelain-like appearance. And in many cases, they have a lot of different varieties with the toadstool leather. As far as price goes on these guys, you can get a frag, which is relatively small, anywhere from $20 to $40. But if you don't feel like grabbing a frag and watching it grow and giving it the time to grow, you want something a little bit bigger, a little bit more established, you can buy a much larger toadstool leather. And typically, this costs a little bit more. You can find them for around $200. That's what I did for the water box. I ended up buying one that was already grown out. It was about 5 inches across. It wasn't of this variety. It's of a toadstool that has kind of like a purplish base and like a green polyp. Absolutely beautiful toadstool leather, but they all are kind of beautiful in their own right, and definitely a coral that is a showpiece in a reef tank. So for most folks, you know, you can go out there and buy those smaller frags, save a little bit of money. But if you're not interested in saving a little bit of money and want something a little bit more grown out and established looking, you can buy those larger specimens of this coral. As far as care level goes for this guy, it's pretty easy to take care of. Not a whole lot of it is going to make it upset. It's pretty hardy. And one thing that is important to mention about toadstool leathers is every month or so, they go through this couple day phase where they don't open up anymore. And then once they start opening up, they actually have like this mucus layer that they shed. Now, this is footage from my cell phone with my toadstool leather. You can see it was one of the first days that it was actually starting to open up, and it was shedding that mucus layer. And that's just part of the natural process with a toadstool leather and something to keep in mind. Coming in at number four in our top five most stunning soft corals is the carnation tree coral. Now, this is a coral that I featured in the top 10 hard to keep corals. And the reason that it is one of the most hard to keep soft corals out there is the fact that it is non-photosynthetic and it requires regular feedings to live. And you'll find this with a lot of corals that are non-photosynthetic and that require feeding to sustain themselves, is they usually get that expert level branding. And usually that has everything to do, again, with its feeding requirements. Some folks have found success with hanging this coral upside down, which is kind of interesting. But in most cases, you think about it, we have our corals pointed up to the light, where this is a non-photosynthetic coral. Pointing it down away from the light maybe increases its chances of extending its polyps. And another trick folks have used to kind of get this guy to feed is actually using amino acids to get those polyps to extend out and ready to accept food, which has all been little tricks that have helped this coral be a little bit more successful. Typical asking price for this coral is anywhere from $40 to $90, and that's really going to depend on the size of the coral that you are receiving. But again, hard to keep coral, but absolutely beautiful. And I'll include a link to the top 10 hardest to keep corals in the description if you guys want to check that video out after you're done with this one. Coming in at number three on the top five most stunning soft corals is the Gorgonian. Now, the Gorgonian is an interesting coral. It's not necessarily one that could be considered soft, but it's not really an SPS or an LPS. It kind of has its own little category, and that has a lot to do with the makeup of this coral, and it's more of a cartilage than it is anything else. It actually has like this weird wiry thing going on in the center of it. So actually, if you go to frag this coral, you're cutting away the flesh and then you're leaving the little wire piece, and you're actually building up the whatever substance you're using for to make a frag plug. So that's why when you receive this coral, a frag of it, quite often it has like this little mound that's built up around it. It's because it's not necessarily something that you can cut and glue to a plug. Now, there's two different types of Gorgonians. You have the photosynthetic type, which is considered easy to care for. Then you have the non-photosynthetic type, which requires feeding. And again, like we talked about earlier in this video, any type of coral that requires feeding is usually considered an expert level care coral. Now, for those of you that are just starting out in the hobby and looking to add a sea fan or Gorgonian to your reef tank, I strongly recommend that you go with a photosynthetic type. In a lot of cases, they are very pretty. There's some absolutely beautiful photosynthetic purple ones out there that make a reef tank look a little bit more like a reef tank. And typical asking price for this coral is anywhere from $20 to $60, and it really depends on whether it is a photosynthetic or non-photosynthetic type, a Gorgonian. Any way you cut it, an absolute beautiful coral. Some require a little bit more care than others, and they are a great addition to any reef tank. Coming in at number two on the top five most stunning soft corals is the clove polyp. Now, this softie is an absolute beauty and is a great addition to any reef tank. As far as price point goes on this guy, not too bad. It's probably anywhere from $20 to $40, depending on the size of the frag. One thing that is important to note about this coral is it is a relatively slow grower. So as far as fragging goes, it's not something that's going to just, you know, completely take over and have a moneymaker on your hands. They are incredibly slow. And there is an exception to that when it comes to clove polyps, and that is the blue clove polyp. It is a absolute beast when it comes to growth rate. And just like many things in this hobby, things that grow a little too fast, especially in a small aquarium, become more of a pest than they do a prized coral. So in many cases, if you are worried about a coral such as the blue clove polyp, you know, overrunning your tank, then that's probably not going to be a great choice for you, especially if you have a smaller aquarium, because who wants a small aquarium full of just one type of coral? We want a reef, and a natural looking reef is one that is well balanced, has a lot of different species of corals in it. Because if there's just one coral in there, it isn't going to look that good. Even though that, you know, our aquariums are small, even when you consider the largest aquariums in relation to a reef, diversity is a key, and it's going to make it look a lot better. Clove polyps, beautiful soft coral, typically a slow growing coral with the exception of the blue clove polyp, and they are a great addition to a reef take. Check them out. And coming in at number one on the top five most stunning soft corals is the bounce mushroom. Now, this mushroom is simply a Rhodactis and quite often brings some of the largest paydays when you are talking about the transfer of ownership with this coral. It has been discussed that someone has paid upwards of $10,000 for a frag. One frag. That's it. Just one frag, $10,000. Now, as time has gone on since this coral was first introduced to the hobby, price has come down a substantial amount. And you can typically find one of these corals from anywhere it's for $1,000 to $500, depending on the vendor. Still a little too rich for my blood, but definitely a very, very beautiful coral. Now, this coral is pretty stunning when you look at it, especially when you have a group of them together. The polyp that is almost ballooned out like is incredibly stunning. And then you have that Rhodactis base that is very familiar and also complements those larger ballooned out polyps very well. So if you're looking to add a bounce of color to your reef tank, take a look at the bounce mushroom. All right, guys, that's going to do it for today's video. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this one, make sure you hit the thumbs up. And if you're new to the channel, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the bell so you can be notified every time that I upload a new video. See you next week. Peace.